Ofre kronkron, hallelujah. Ofre yi, eye ofre kronkron, hallelujah. Nti ye nyami sum yi, ye be sum ni ya, wo se, ye she, ye ni ya bravo yi, hallelujah. Ya ye Kristo fo yi, se o she opo, na se nam ye be ba, adi bako a wo se, ye she pa, e ya kuma, hallelujah. Nti anopi, me kasa afa akumano hum, the heart, hallelujah. Me kasa afa akumano hum. Hallelujah. Amen. Ntino, se ushe Bible ma, yaka akuma, ma, primary part ni de, into three process, or si mental process, adrenal, any emotion, se niya, uti, enka, ana, uti, ana se, enkaye, hallelujah, ena, the will of God, ana se, nyamepe, hallelujah. Akuma no ɛyɛ honam nyinaa ne fapem, the center of one's being. Nti no kan Proverbs chapter 4 verse 23. Proverbs chapter 4 verse 23. Atabet ma kan. Brofuno si guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it proceeds all the issues of life. Guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Atabet ma kan chi na mayen. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mika o mebu sa meti na chiche mu edio no miensa. Ose kwa wakuma, esle diye wudi siye eni na. Na emu ena enkwa edifre efi. Amen.
Hallelujah. Si ne emu na debe enkwa edifre efi. Hallelujah. Inti no, ye Kristo fu yi na wose to be ekra ya kuma yi. Because emu ene bufo otay envy. Jealousy. Emu ene efriba. Hallelujah. Ti ya ye e Kristo fu yi. Anase ya ye jidye fu yi. Wose ye to be ekra ya kuma yi. Hallelujah. You know, I hear center of one's being at a side of the beer, yet GDA every hallelujah. A commanding a beer, GDA every ever. You know, can Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10 now. Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. I say, Nasa Udi, Wano, Pemuka, say, Yesu ni iradi. Now Udi Wakuma, GD say, Onyan coupon, Anya Nunu Efi, Ufuma. Same thing, so Udi. Udi wakuma, nti na akuma mu no ena gidie efri, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Nti no si na akuma no na udi ji ekɔ tin ni ye mu, hallelujah. Nti udi wakuma no ena edi akɔ tin ni ye mu. Nti no se akuma no eni hɔ a ana se wakuma no embre no hasi ema nyankopon asema ebe din kra se obeji edi akọ tini ni mu ana se obeji edi akọ enkwajim. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Ntino ena ye koso as oho akuma no mu na ye hu se okay boni ewo ha ana se we ye boni ana we ye papa ye. Hallelujah. Ntino see in 1 Kings chapter 3 verse 9, see, Mawakua, so give your servant a discerning heart to govern your people and to distinguish between right and wrong. It's akumanu mono ena utimi anase utimi di ehu se adena yokoso no eye papa ana bone. It's no she brofunuma or see a heart wa odi coaching ma omaye ni na adwin. It's no timu se adwin no ene akumanu eye chuma ti yaka akuma enye our physical heart are you, but akuma ni ye inna ana se adia ewo ye mu aye ntumi enye part na ewo body mouth ubetumi di doctors for tumi di omu saka da de enye na meka akuma ye ka akuma Bible edi ho adanse nti se o se guard your heart with all diligence. Opa chira o se honhuma Who my woman? I was so to me a bon woman did not crow a come ye, because a buffoon airbano at Miss Enyama. It has been proven, says, I'm sorry, Becoia. Hallelujah. Say, I'm sorry, Ebecoia. I was saying, members, no woman, or say, or Macuma, a papa. It's you know, say, I'm sorry, Uncoia. And members, no woman, members, no, I saw him now and crack my pa. People of a wrong heart. It is very difficult for the church to progress. And as I saw you know, Ebecoini. Hallelujah. It is a sorry, Ebecoini ma. And I said, I'm sorry, Ebekoso Aji, Amamaya, I was saying, you know, Yajima, oh, Yakumim. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And you know, I say, Akumano, Yansubain, Nifapim, is the center of one's character. To look at Matthew chapter 15, verse 18. Memory verse needles into the woman, make I know what Matthew 15, verse 18, to Kofia. Matthew 15, verse 18. I see, but the things that come out of a person's mouth come from their heart, and these defile them. Matthew 15, verse 18.
My, it's do no chichemu don't watch it. Or say, Nadia, a free anumu, a free adia no. A free onipa akumemu na eno ena ebu onipa emufi. Amen.
Amen. Inti no say u kasa no ubi hum because unkrofutu oha unhu ama. It is very difficult to be able to be unhu character and also be to be unhu musubai. But from umukasa no ena echiro say okay onipa we say you can judge slightly based on the way onipa ni kasa. Hallelujah. Inti onipa ni kasa muno. Et me mau en who say oh the power ni suni ni ni ye say net ye mo homu ye din but omunya kasape. Hallelujah. So we have some people who are very quiet or introvert in nature.
Your gophobia omu de send your mutiano omu ye cool abigina say na mutye.
And we also have people who are extrovert in nature. But in our setting, or in our African settings, no. People who are extrovert are associated with people who are rude, and people who are introvert are associated with humility. But it can be deceptive.
Hallelujah.
The reason is because everything springs from the heart. The Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Hallelujah. So when your heart is full of evil,
and it's akumanimu,
you bring forth what is evil. So when you read Matthew chapter 12, out of the good man,
the papa,
out of the good treasures of his heart,
the person
brings forth what is good.
On
and an evil man, out of the evil treasures of his heart, brings forth what is evil.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And that is Luke 6:45.
As I'm putting a look at you,
so if you read the reason why God destroyed the earth for the first time in Genesis, the account of Genesis 6.
Said to pray, I say as I say, Genesis woman say.
It reads that and God saw that Genesis 6:5.
I want Genesis woman say.
And God saw that the imagination, the wickedness of man was great on the earth, and that every imagination of the thought of his heart was only evil continually. So the evil nature of man's heart was what led to God destroying the earth in the time of Noah. Hallelujah. So the thing is, when you are a man of integrity,
so you nipa ko mu die mu a,
or you are an innocent man, God himself will testify for you. God himself will testify for you.
So
when you read the account of Genesis chapter 20 verse 1-6, when Abraham was pilgriming from his home to the promised land, or to the land of promise,
Abraham
he met a Gentile king.
Now,
a Gentile king, or a
Ochi,
his name was Abimelech. So when he met Abimelech, he introduced Sarah as his sister. Hallelujah. So Abimelech thought that, oh, okay, Sarah was the sister of Abraham.
So
if that be the case, then I will take her as my wife. But at night, something ensued between God and Abimelech. So let's read Genesis chapter 20,
verse 4 and 6.
But if you go home, you can read from the verse 1 to the 6. But
Abimelech
had not slept with her yet. So he said, Lord, will you destroy an innocent nation? Didn't Abraham tell me,
Abraham anka se,
she is my sister, and she herself said, he is my brother. I acted in complete innocence. My hands are clean. Verse 6. In the dream, God responded, yes, I know you are innocent. That's why I kept you from sinning against me. And why I did not let you touch her. So the long and short of this reading, God saw integrity in the heart of Abimelech. So that is why he didn't even destroy Abimelech or kill
Abimelech.
So Abimelech even testified that he was innocent. And God approved his innocency. So can God find integrity in your heart this morning? Can God find integrity in your heart this morning? So God knows when you are doing something from the integrity of your heart. So as a church, if the church will progress, the members have to be committed. They have to come out from their own will. Give their all to the service of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People with integrity in their heart, God calls them innocent. When your heart is right, you know it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say that when your heart is right, you yourself, you know it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So most of us, especially we, the singles, we are praying to God for marriage. But God is checking your heart. Is your heart ready to meet the guy or the lady you want to marry? As married people here too, God is also checking your heart. How do you relate to your spouse at home? And as children also, God is checking our heart. How do we relate to our parents at home? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's read Proverbs chapter 23, verse 7. For as he thinks in his heart,
23:7.
For as he thinks in his heart,
so
is he.
Sanity.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So as you are thinking in your heart, so you are. Because from the heart, then it comes from the mouth. So Jesus Christ when he was speaking on the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 5. From the verse 17 to the verse
48.
Jesus was saying he didn't come to destroy the law. But he came to fulfill the law. And in so doing, you know, he started explaining what he meant by giving the Israelite the law. And everything, if you read carefully, you realize everything was directing to the heart.
So what kind of year was it? Bibia and you can equine akumano.
Say it is written.
Say your choice, say.
You shall not murder.
Say me dear.
But Jesus Christ said,
Jesus Christ said,
if you get angry at your brother,
so
you have already committed murder in your heart. So Jesus Christ was trying to address the issues of the heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that is why. And when the he asked one, what is the greatest commandment?
And
the
minister said,
he summarized all into two.
So,
thou shalt love the Lord your God with all your heart. With all your mind. And with all your power. And the second is like this. Thou shalt love your neighbor as yourself. If your heart is not good, how can you extend a loving heart to your friend? You can't do that. So if you don't love your brother or your sister, what shows that you love God? So the law was summarized in only two. And we saw the Ten Commandments in that too. Because the first four commandments was captured in thou shalt love the Lord with all your heart and with all your might and with all your
strength.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the next six was your association with your neighbor.
And also you said you are willing to.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So love springs from the heart also. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if your love is genuine,
or
fake.
Say if
you yourself you know. And God will testify for that.
Because
the issues of the heart. It is only God. It is only God who can detect whether you are plotting evil or you are plotting good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God should help us. So David, when he was praying in Psalm 51, verse 10, said, create in me a clean heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if your heart is not clean, God cannot renew a right spirit within you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Always we want God to renew our spirit. But
have
we checked our heart?
Nah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you see, the Bible is step by step, line by line. You don't jump steps.
Just a moment, you read it that way.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Bible says, create in me a clean heart.
And
renew a right spirit within me.
And now say,
so when the heart is not clean, the spirit cannot be renewed. So for revival to take place, for God to renew our spirit man, then we have to check our hearts. We have to work on our hearts. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So touch your heart.
Touch,
touch Touch your heart.
So I come in
and tell God.
That can you imagine?
God, give me a soft and a good heart.
And we are doing our command and bread and papa.
God, give me a good and a soft heart.
We are doing our command and papa and bread.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As Job prayed.
Now Job a bonfire.
He prayed the same prayer we are praying now.
Now, but some prayers are.
Job 23:16.
Job, who can Job who might tell
say, so for God makes my heart soft.
And we are doing our command and bread.
For God makes my heart soft.
So
it should be our prayer. That if we have hardened heart, a heart that is resistance to the word of God, then God should make our heart soft. So the Bible says, David was praying the prayer, and from the scriptures, you realize the answer was not coming. So when you read Psalm 66:18,
so we can hear a new edition.
Let me pray the prayer.
Say,
if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. So that means iniquity in your heart is a hindrance to prayers.
And say,
hallelujah.
Amen.
So as believers,
say,
as one people in the vineyard, if you want our prayers heard, then we have to check whether there is iniquity or sin
in our heart.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Bible says in Psalm 34:18, the Lord is near unto them that are of a broken heart. So if you want the Lord to be near you, then you should have a broken heart. It is not a broken heart that your boyfriend or your girlfriend will give you, but a heart that is broken for God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So your words and attitude show the state of your mind.
So
I ask the reader to read Matthew 12:33-45
for me.
Ena wodi emudu yakro eruti ama moye abonifo yi mobeye den etumi aka ensempa na die aye akomamu ma ebusuo no eno na ano eka onipa bempi nipa waboabo na komamu no emu ena woyi nipa edie na onipa boni so efi ne boni a waboabo no na komamu no.
Amen. So as the reading went, so the state of your heart determines the state of your mind. So he says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when God is in your heart, hallelujah. When God is in your heart, there are things that you do. Immediately you finish.
So
if it is not for the benefit of the people around you, if it's not to enlarge the scope of God's kingdom, God will start speaking to you that what we did was not right. But if your heart is hard, It is very difficult for even God to speak to you.
Because
when he's speaking to you, you will resist it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So the state of your heart determines the state of your mind. So when your heart is sound,
it reflects
in your spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When your heart is sound, it reflects in your spirit. So when you read Proverbs chapter 14, verse
30,
a sound heart is the life of the flesh. Is the life of the flesh. But envy, the rottenness of the bones. So envy starts from within. Then it will rotten everything that is within you.
So,
as you are walking, you are even a time bomb. Because from within you, you know, you have stored hatred. There is too much envy. But if you want your heart to be sound, or if you want a sound spirit, or a calm nature.
So open say wanga sa uye wakuma mujo anase wanga sano unipedia eno eye bokodia.
Then we should check your heart.
And she wakuma.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So Proverbs chapter 15 verse 13. Proverbs 15 verse 13.
Eye ye kan ye mewisem etie ye dunum eyi ma dunum yensa.
Says a merry heart.
Akuma embre.
Makes a cheerful countenance. But the sorrow of the heart. The spirit is broken. So be cheerful. As a Christian. Be cheerful. Because when you are not cheerful, or you are someone always. You put up a loose face or you frown your face. Then you have to check yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 For he said he has called us from darkness into his marvelous light. So if he has called us from darkness into his marvelous light, then we have to be cheerful. Because we have a hope. And that is Christ in us.
And they say, yes,
the hope of glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the issue is when we are in church.
Say what so them.
When we are even worshiping God.
Say so they are.
To even worship God, no, our hearts should be clean.
Say yes, so they say emotion.
So if you read Psalm 24, verse 3 and 4.
Okay, I know.
This I want the reader. Psalm 24:3-4. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. He said, who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord?
What about for
or who shall stand in his holy place? So to stand in the holy place of God. These are the qualified people who can stand in the holy place of God. He that has clean hands and a pure heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who has not lifted up his soul unto vanity,
nor
sworn deceitfully. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, if you want to always abide in the presence of God, you have to always check your heart. Hallelujah. So as I wrap up my message, It is my prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is my prayer. And I want to take my prayer from Ezekiel chapter
36,
verse
2.
If any of us is here who has a hardened heart, a stony heart, a heart that is able to resist revival, as we await the revival of God, possess the nations, God should soften our heart. He should give us a heart of flesh. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I read Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 26. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if God can renew our spirit, then he has to give us a new heart.
So
it is my prayer that God will give us a new heart. God should create in us a new heart. He should, and renew a right spirit within us. So may the Lord give you uprightness of your heart. May he give you a pure and a soft spirit in the name of Jesus. May God bless you. Amen.
Amen.